Welcome back to the channel, I'm Lauren Fix, and this is the 2023 Mazda CX-5. This is the number one seller for Mazda, and it's 50% of their sales, and it's a very important vehicle. And there are some changes for 2023, not a lot, but let's see how this compares to all the competitors. And believe me, there's a lot, including the Honda CR-V and many others, and we'll put that list down below. One of the things you'll note right away is LED headlights and taillights, and I do like these daytime running lights, or DRLs. They really did a nice job. Overall, there was no changes to the front of this vehicle. I will let you know the reason that this Mazda logo is so large is they put all their safety features behind that, all the cameras and the LiDAR, so that they can have it all in one location. It's also up high enough so that a stone doesn't hit it. But overall, this vehicle looks nice and clean, and I really do like this pearl white color. The CX-5 rides on 19-inch alloy rims and all-season tires. There are no exterior changes to the side of this vehicle, but it does carry a 6-year, 60,000-mile warranty and roadside service. Coming around to the back of the vehicle, you can see there are LED taillights, and very similar to what you've seen before, that CX-5, our test vehicle, is a signature all-wheel drive. It's the Skyactiv, and it is the turbocharged engine. Overall, there's not a lot of changes to the back, but it's nice and clean, and that's what makes this vehicle very popular. It's modern in design. The Mazda CX-5 seats 5 people, 8-way power driver's side seat with lumbar and 2 memory settings. Really easy to use and very comfortable seating. On the passenger side, there is power seating, but there is no lumbar. Going into the second row, there is optional heated seats, such as the front has, and the front seats also have optional vented seating, and of course, there is a heated steering wheel. As far as leg space for the CX-5, it is a bit tighter. There are pockets behind each of the seats, and there is ventilation and, of course, storage in the doors. Pull down that center armrest, and there is even more. There is 3-stage heated seats for both sides, as well as cup holders and additional storage. It's kind of odd to have this here because if a third person is sitting in the seat, you can't adjust the controls, but they wouldn't get the heated seats anyhow. These seats do have 2 child safety latches, and it splits 60-40 to get back to the cargo area. The seats do not recline. The Mazda is a very practical car. There's a lot of controls that are easy to use, including all your collision adjustments here, and your cruise control is over on this side. And again, all those adjustments, the lane centering and so forth, is really easy to use. In front of you have real gauges, which I really appreciate, especially as people keep these vehicles for a long time. Having real gauges is much better than digital gauges, although the digital gauges are cooler. They're very practical when it comes to Mazda because people do keep them longer. There's your shifting for your paddle shifters and your wipers. On the left side, you've got your shifting and your lights. On the left side of the steering wheel, you've got additional controls for parking and so forth. And down below is your hood and your gas door, which is appreciated with the price of gasoline. People are doing silly things these days. Regular controls for mirrors and locks are on the door, as well as additional storage. Mazda navigation comes along with it, and unfortunately, it is a bit dated when it comes to some of the new navigation systems of today. This is a Bose audio system that has AM, FM, Sirius XM, Android, Apple, and Apple CarPlay, which is plug-in. Further down on the dial from navigation is settings, and that's how you get into your safety settings and additional information that you may want to adjust based on making it your own. Going further down are 2 nicely designed ducts, and one over here on the right for air, your glove box, and your heated steering wheel button is right here, as well as your push button start stop. Further down is climate control, nothing unusual, what we're all used to. There is an outlet for radar detector or whatever you need to charge, and there is wireless charging, which is appreciated. Further back is your standard Prindle, just a normal shifter, and further back are your drive modes. Mazda's infotainment controls are right here, your home button, music, navigation, going back and making your favorites are here, parking brake and auto hold. Behind that is 2 cup holders. Inside the glove box is additional storage and more charging. Up above is a place for your sunglasses, lighting, and your sunroof, and that is a manual cover. The Mazda CX-5 has a National Highway Traffic Safety Administration 5-star crash test rating, and that is excellent. There's a lot of safety features, and they are standard. They're here in the center screen, and they're also adjustable on the screen in front of you. You can go into these driver assistance features with the radar cruise control, your speed limiters, and so forth. Tilt that little center control to the right. You've got your safety alerts, your active safety, which includes your lane keeping assist, which I think is really a good thing to have, the collision avoidance, which also includes blind spot monitoring, lane departure warning, lane keep assist, rear cross traffic alert, which is one of my favorites, smart city brake support in reverse, and radar cruise control. And again, these are adjustable, including your monitors and your parking sensors, and there's descriptions for each. In the center screen, press that info button in the middle and goes right over to the different settings, and you can adjust those settings based on what you need. Again, a lot of this is adjustable, so you can pick what you want on and what you want off, your trip, and of course, your different controls for lane centering. Under the hood of our test vehicle is a 2.5-liter turbocharged engine with 227 horsepower and 310 pound-feet of torque. SkyActiv 6-speed automatic transmission backs it up. Fuel economy, 24 miles to the gallon combined. Our 0 to 60 time is 6.6 seconds and a towing capacity of up to 2,000 pounds. They're all-wheel drive with that standard iActiv all-wheel drive system riding on 19-inch wheels. Driving the Mazda CX-5, it has the iActiv all-wheel drive, and because I live in the Buffalo area, that would give me confidence to have all-wheel drive and all-season tires to drive this vehicle year-round, which you should have that kind of confidence. This is a 5-passenger family SUV, and it's super popular because it gives people everything that they want. Now, as far as ride on some of the rough roads here in New York State, the ride is actually pretty nice. It absorbs a lot of the bumps and deep divots and potholes and all the rest of the crap. See, it's driving right over them like it's not even there. Now, I'm driving in normal mode. Now, if you drop it into the sport mode, there's also an off-road mode, and you would need to have an off-road trail to take this on. It would be light off-roading. This is not going to be heavy off-roading. You'll see that right away that it has a little bit more spunk. Takes off. And that's where you can get your fastest 0 to 60 times. Honestly, I like driving it in the normal mode. I think that just makes the most sense for this vehicle. It's what you need to transport your family, get to the places you need and the things you need to do. And I think that's where this vehicle hits its sweet spot. Now, if you're thinking about something that gets good fuel economy, yes, there's a lot of competitors in this category, but getting something that's going to have good resale value and that's going to be reliable for you, I think, is your biggest factor. Brakes are nice, easy to drive, handling, not a problem at all. Again, this is why people drive this car. They're looking at the competitors, and it comes down to price and insurance rates. That's where your big variable is going to be. And it's going to be different for everybody because obviously insurance rates change all the time. But as far as this vehicle in itself, it's got good pickup, it's got good handling, and it really fits in with a lot of the competitors that are in this category. When it comes to visibility, there's a huge piece of glass in front as well as an around view backup camera, which I think is really important. Another thing that I like to do with a lot of these SUVs is to do a 3-point turn. So we'll pull over here and we'll see how the 3-point turn is. Wow, it's actually almost does the complete circle. That's really good turning radius. Anybody could do this. Makes it easier to find parking spots, get into those tight spots, and of course it makes it easier to drive on a daily basis. Coming around to the back, there's 30.8 cubic feet of storage. Underneath this cover is a spare tire. And that is a positive because a lot of the competitors don't have it. They use run flats. That's a major plus. Fold down those second row seats and you're at 59.3 cubic feet of storage. The 2023 Mazda CX-5 comes in different trim levels, as low as $26,700, and then all the way up to the top trim level, which is what we have here, that comes in at $39,700. Our test vehicle had additional options, which brought it in at $41,600. This is a very popular vehicle with excellent resale value and reasonably priced insurance rates, which is also important when you look at some of the competitors. You've got the Honda CR-V, the Kia Seltos, the Hyundai Tucson. There's a lot of vehicles in this category. And like I said in the beginning, we'll list them down below in the description. We reviewed them all, and it'll give you a chance to test drive all the different vehicles beforehand. So when you go to the dealer, you'll know what meets your needs. Now, there are some pros and cons. On the positive side, it has excellent pickup, considering that it also has a turbocharge option if that's what you choose to get. There is also a very nice upscale interior. On the negative side, I'm really not a fan of that interface being so dated compared to some of the competitors in the category, and there is tighter leg space than there is in some of the others. There is no hybrid option or plug-in available at this time, but there is the Mazda CX-50, which we have reviewed, and you want to check that out before you make your decision. They are very similar, but remember, this is a very important vehicle to Mazda, so make sure that you test drive both the CX-5 and the CX-50. One of them is going to meet your needs. I'm sure you have additional questions when it comes to the Mazda CX-5. Put that down in the comments below. I'll be happy to answer them. If you own one of these, we'd love to get your feedback. Others are interested as well. If you got value from this video, make sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this one. If you'd like to support us, you can buy me a cup of coffee. The link for that is in the description, as well as for the website, the podcast, and the book, and of course, my social media. Thank you so much for watching. We'll look forward to seeing you next time.